वेलकम टू ई लेक्चर सीरीज फॉर बीटेक 4SEM सब्जेक्ट डाटा कम्युनिकेशन एंड कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क। माई सेल्फ प्रकाश मीना, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद अवर टॉपिक। ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस। द टॉपिक इज नेटवर्क सॉफ्टवेयर, इन विच वी विल स्टडी प्रोटोकॉल हायरार्कीज एंड सम टर्मिनोलॉजीज एंड आफ्टर द डिजाइन इश्यूज ऑफ द लेयर्स एट लास्ट इन शॉर्ट। Let's start. Network software is currently highly structured, and for this to reduce their design complexity, most networks are organized as a stack of layers or levels, each one built upon the one below it, and the number of layers, the name of each layers, the content of each layer and the function of each layer different from network to network, and the purpose of each network is to offer certain services to the higher layers while shielding those layers from the details of how the offered services are actually implemented. In a sense, each layer is a kind of virtual machine offering certain services to the layer above it. Sorry. This concept is actually a familiar one and is used throughout computer science, where it is known as information hiding, abstract data types, data encapsulation, and object-oriented programming. So the fundamental idea is that a particular piece of software or hardware provides a service to the its user, but keeps the details of its internal state and algorithm hidden from them. And when layer n on one machine carries on a conversation with layer n on another machine, the rules and conventions used in the conversations are collectively known as the layer protocol. And basically, a protocol is an agreement between the communicating parties on how communication is to proceed. Then a five-layer network, here you can see illustrated here. So layers, protocol, interfaces, and pre-physical medium, layer 1 to 5, you can see host 1 and host 2. So the entities comprising the corresponding layers on different machines are called peers, and the peers may be software processes, hardware devices, or even human beings. And in other words, it is the peer that communicate by using the protocol to talk to each other. Then in reality, no data are directly transferred from layer N on one machine to layer N on another machine, and each layer passes data and control information information to the layer immediately below it, until the lowest layer is reached, and below layer 1 is the physical medium through which actual communication occurs. And you can see in figure, virtual communication is shown by dotted lines and physical communication is by solid lines. And between each pair of the adjacent layer is an interface. The interface defines which primitive operations and services the lower layer makes available to the upper one. When network designers decide how many layers to include in a network and what each one should do, one of the most important consideration is the defining clean interfaces between layers. Doing so requires that each layer performs a specific collection of well understood functions, in addition to minimizing the amount of information that must be passed between layers. Clear-cut interfaces also make it simpler to replace one layer with a completely different protocol or implementation. Because all that is required of the new protocol or implementation is that it offers exactly the same set of services to its upstairs neighbors as the old one did. And it is common that different hosts use different implementations of the same protocol, and the protocol itself changes in some layers without the layer above and below it even noticing. So a set of layers and protocol is called a network architecture. The specification of an architecture must contain enough information to allow the implementer to write the program or to build the hardware for each layer so that it will correctly obey the appropriate protocol. Neither the detail of implementation nor the specification of the interface is part of the architecture, and because these are in, hidden away inside the machines and not visible from the outside, and it is not even necessary that the interfaces on all machines in a network be the same, and provided that each machine can correctly use all the protocols, and a list of protocol used by a certain system or one protocol per layer is called a protocol stack. Now network software, we can say all this is a network software, but it is worth pointing out that the lower layers of a protocol hierarchy are frequently implemented in hardware or firmware. So you can see this hardware and firmware terms for more information. Then design issues of the layers. Some of the key design issues that occurs in computer networks will come up in layers after layer, and we can see here some terminologies. And main issues also here. So start with reliability is the design issue of making a network that operate correctly. Even though it is made up of a collection of components that are themselves unreliable, think about the bits of a packet traveling through the network. There is a chance that some of these bits will be received damaged, and due to electrical noise or random wireless signals, hardware flaws, software bugs, and so on, are many types of impairments. So how it is possible that we find and fix these errors? So one mechanism for finding errors in receiving information user code for error detection. So information that is incorrectly received can then be retransmitted until it is received correctly, and more powerful codes allow for error correction where the correct message is recovered from the possibly incorrect bits that were originally received. And both of these mechanisms work by adding redundant information. They are used at low layers to protect packets sent over individual links, and high layers to check that the right contents were received. Another reliability issue is finding a working path through a network, and often there are multiple paths between a source and destinations. In a large network, there may be some link or routers that are broken. And suppose that the network is down, for example, down in Germany, packets sent from London to Rome via Germany will not get through, but we could instead send packets from London to Rome via Paris. The network should automatically make this decision, and this topic is called routing. So second issue concerned the evolution of the network. So you can say over time networks grows larger and new design emerge that need to be connected to the existing network, and we have recently seen the key structuring mechanism used to support this change by dividing the overall problems and hiding in implementation details, and this is called as protocol layering, and there are many other strategies as well. And since there are many computers on the network, every layers need a mechanism for identifying the senders and receivers that are involved in a particular message. So this mechanism is called addressing and naming in the low and higher layers respectively. So an aspect of growth is that different network technologies often have different limitations, and not all communication channels preserve the order of messages sent on them, leading to solutions that number messages. And so Another example is difference in the maximum size of a message that the network can transmit. This leads to mechanisms for disassembling, transmitting and then reassembling messages. This overall topic is called internetworking. And when network gets large, new problems arise. So for we need some more network or more systems. So design that continue to work well when the network gets large are said to be scalable. So it is expandable also. And then a third design issue is resource allocation. The network provides a service to host from their underlying resources such as the capacity of transmission lines, and to do this well, they need mechanisms that divide their resources so that one host does not interfere with another too much. Then many designs share networks bandwidth dynamically according to the short term needs of host, and rather than by giving each host a fixed function of the bandwidth that it may or may not use. This design is called statistical multiplexing, meaning sharing based on the statistics of demand. It can be applied at low layers for a single link, or at higher layers for a network or even application that use the network. An allocation problem that occurs at every level is how to keep a fast sender from swamping a slow receiver with data. So feedback from the receiver to the sender is often used. So this is related to flow control, and sometimes the problem is that the network is oversubscribed because too many computers want to send too much traffic and network cannot deliver it all. So this overloading of the network is called congestion, and one strategy is for each computer to reduce its demands. When it experiences a congestion, it can be used in all layers, and it is interesting to observe that the network has more resources to offer than simply bandwidth. And for users such as carrying live videos, the timeliness of delivery matters a great deal, and most network must provide services to applications that want this real-time delivery at the same time that they provide services in applications that want high throughput. And the quality of service is the name given to mechanism that reconciles these competing demands. And the last major design issue is to secure the network by defending it against different kinds of threats. One of threats we have already mentioned previously is that of eavesdropping on communications. So mechanisms that provide confidentiality depend against the threat, and they are used in multiple layers. And mechanisms for authentication prevent someone from impersonating someone else, and they might be used to tell fake banking websites from the real one, or to let the cellular network check that a call is really coming from one phone, so that you will pay the bill properly. And one other mechanism for integrity prevents suspicious changes in messages, and such as altering debit someone's account to debit another one's account, and the amount will be changed. So all of these designs are based on cryptography. So that's all about design issues of the layers. So session ends here. Thank you.